We will start the press conference by Minister Motegi. Minister, please. Briefly, there are two reports from myself. First of all, as a result of the election of the judges of the ICJ this morning, the incumbent, Judge Dr. Yuji Iwasawa, was re-elected, winning the largest number of votes amongst the five elected and was successfully elected with the largest votes. Of course, he has very high achievements, but we do appreciate that Japan's attitude to firmly respect the rule of law is highly recognized by the international community. It is highly significant for Japanese persons to serve on key positions of international organizations, not only as ICJ judges. So far, Japanese persons have served as the chief of major international organizations of five UN-related organizations, others including International Telecom Union and the IAEA. Japanese heads of organizations are also currently active at Asian Development Bank or World Customs Organization and others. Of course, we do not think this is sufficient. And in order to provide the quality talents as the chief and senior officers of international organizations, medium and long-term efforts will continue. Hey.
Another point, I wish to talk about the new project of Ministry of Foreign Affairs starting this fiscal year. The Ministry of Foreign Affairs, along with the Department of Defense Education Authority, in regions where there are U.S. military establishments and areas, will be implementing an exchange program with local junior high school students and children of the U.S. military. We will do this hand in hand with the U.S. military and the relevant local governments. The first in the series will be conducted on the 5th and 6th of December in Misawa City. And after that, next year in January and in February, we will be implementing the program in order in Sasebo City and Iwakuni cities. And the students will wear masks, and they will be watertight in their countermeasures for COVID-19. And we will be leveraging schools in the U.S. Military facilities and areas, and exchanges will take place with the children of the military in English. We hope that such exchange programs will enhance mutual understanding between the local community and the U.S. military in Japan, stationed in Japan. And we hope that this will feed into human resource development who will be active on the international community. We'd like to entertain questions. Please, when you are called upon, please proceed to the microphone and state your name and affiliation before you ask your question. Please go ahead.
Independent Web Journal, Hamamoto-san. IWJ Internet Media, my name is Hamamoto. Thank you. Regarding yesterday's telephone conference between Prime Minister Suga and President-elect Mr. Biden, I have a question. The Minister of Foreign Affairs said that Mr. Biden has mentioned that he will commit to the application of Article 5 of the Security Agreement regarding the official readout of the group under Article 5 of the Security Agreement. The deep commitment the U.S. was emphasized is what is described, and there is no reference to Senkaku Island. According to the MOFA announcement, it sounds as if the U.S. side started to refer to Senkaku. I would like to confirm, was it that Japan additionally confirmed about the Senkaku by Japan regarding the portion of Senkaku? Did Mr. No. That is not the case. No? That is my response. It is not. What do you mean by it is not? I am saying that what you're saying is not correct. That is your response? Yes. Thank you very much.
Next question, please. NHK, Yamamoto-san, please. Yamamoto from NHK. In relation to this, regarding the telephone conference yesterday, in the House of Councillors, the Foreign Relations Committee, you said that it was a good conference. What part of this telephone conference do you evaluate highly with Prime Minister Suga and the President-elect, Mr. Biden, had a telephone conference. Initially, he congratulated the president-elect and vice president-elect. And this morning, I talked with Prime Minister Suga. He said it was a very substantial and friendly conversation. From Prime Minister Suga, with regard to the surrounding areas where there is can be seen becoming increasingly severe, the alliance is important, and that for international peace and prosperity, it is also indispensable. And he said that he wished to strengthen the alliance toward the realization of free and open Indo-Pacific. From Biden, President-elect, the application of, to Senkaku Islands of Article 5 of the Japan-U.S. Security Treaty, the commitment to this was expressed, and toward the peace and stability of the Indo-Pacific, he was looking forward to cooperating and also to strengthen U.S.-Japan alliance. And corona countermeasures and climate change issues, common issues to the international community. Regarding this, there was an agreement that there'll be closer cooperation between Japan and U.S. Cooperation regarding the abduction issue is something that the Prime Minister requested. And in this way, time was rather limited and the talks were limited, but the content was very substantial. That is how I evaluate it. Thank you.
Next question, please. Once again, Hamamoto-san. Thank you. Hamamoto of IWJ. So the Trump administration only 70 days left, and following Secretary Esper, three high officials of the DOD have resigned, according to the report. According to Chinese Global Times, and before this report, within the Sino-U.S. relationship, that it could fall into insanity regarding Taiwan and South China Sea. The tension between U.S. and China might be exacerbated. What is the analysis of the Ministry of Foreign Affairs? Thank you. Between U.S. and Japan, under Trump administration as well, and even in the incoming administration, regarding regional situations, exchange of opinions, coordination are taking place. We are trying to share our recognition. We are also trying to coordinate our reaction and response for all situations.
Other questions, please? No questions? If so, we'd like to conclude our press conference at this point. Thank you very much.